हेलो क्लास, इन दिस रिवीजन लेक्चर वी विल बी स्टडीइंग अबाउट इंट्रोडक्शन टू लॉ ऑफ डॉट्स, कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ डॉट्स एंड जॉइंट डॉट पीसेस। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। फर्स्ट वी विल बी डूइंग द मीनिंग ऑफ डॉट। द वर्ड डॉट हैज बीन डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम अ लैटिन वर्ड डॉटस व्हिच मींस रॉन्ग और क्रूकेड। एनीथिंग व्हिच इज क्रूकेड, व्हिच इज नॉट स्ट्रेट, व्हिच इज ट्विस्टेड, व्हिच इज नोटोरियस, व्हिच इज रॉन्ग, दैट मींस डॉट। It is equivalent to the English word which is wrong. Thus, tort in common law is a civil wrong. The nature of tort law is thus essentially concerned with compensation of damages. Basically, tort is not a crime. It is a wrongful act, but it is not an offense as per IPC because it is not grave as crime. It is a wrong act, and the main objective of tort is to get the compensation in the form of damages, and damages means compensation in the form of money. The main aim of tort law is to restore the position of the person who has suffered the wrong. So for restoring the position of the person who has suffered the wrong, the judiciary, the judges tend to take the compensation, take the money compensation from the person who has done the wrong and give it to the person who has suffered the wrong. Now there are two terms. The person who has done the wrong is known as the defendant, and the person who has suffered the wrong is known as the plaintiff. Now, the constituents of tort. Tort is a private wrong that contravenes the legal right of an individual or a group. Tort is a wrong which private wrong which contravenes only a legal right of an individual or a group. It is not a wrong towards the whole public or whole community. Like crime is a wrong which is said to be done towards the whole public or community. For example, murder is such a grave offense, or rape is such a grave offense, or theft is such a grave offense that it tends to shake the conscience of the whole society, whole set of public living in that, people living in that society. So it is considered as a wrong towards the society. But tort is a private wrong which infringes the legal right of a particular individual only, or of a group of people along with a particular individual, not the whole society. Person who commits the tort is called tortfeasor. Tort is a civil wrong. Tort litigation is compoundable, which means that if a complaint is filed, then it can also be withdrawn. But in criminal law, it is not compoundable. A complaint is not compoundable. But tort law, a complaint is compoundable. After lodging the complaint also, if out of court settlement is provided, then it can be done. Tort is a species of infringement of a person's right or civil wrong, which I have already told you, and damages are paid in tort, and damages are in form of pecuniary damages, that is, money is paid as a way of compensation, which we call as damages. Damages is the term which we call for money compensation in tort. It is paid by the defendant, that is the tortfeasor, wrongdoer, to the plaintiff, that is the person who has suffered the tort. And after the damages are paid, it is said that the defendant has restored the position of the person who has suffered the tort, that is, plaintiff. Now, what are tortfeasors? When a tort is committed by several persons, in addition to this, all the persons will be responsible for the same tort and will be deemed to be joint wrongdoers in the eyes of law. If a tort is committed by one person, that person is called tortfeasor. If one tort is committed by several people, then that is called joint tortfeasor. All those people are called joint tortfeasor. Now, circumstances under which joint liability arises: agency, vicarious liability, and joint or common action. Agency means when a principal assigns a work to the agent and agent does that work in the course of his employment, and out of doing that work, a tort is committed. So both the principal and agent would be considered as joint tortfeasor. In vicarious liability, like employer-employee relationship, if the employee is assigned by some work by the employer in his course of employment and the employee does that work, then the employer would also be liable because the work was assigned by the employer to the employee in his course of employment, and both would be considered as joint tortfeasors. Joint or common action, when one person incites the other person to do an act, like जिसे हम कहते हैं उकसाना, एक ने उकसाया दूसरे ने किया, both would be considered as joint tortfeasors. See class, I've also shared detailed notes in about all these topics, so kindly go through them, and you can also go through your own notes and online sources of book, and if you find any problem in all of these, please get back to me. Thank you class, I'll be more than happy to help you. I just missed out this slide before I end up the lecture. The nature of liability, joint tortfeasor's liability, this needs to be explained. See, it is when two people are together liable to the plaintiff as joint tortfeasor for the commission of a tort, then the discretion is on the plaintiff that whether he wants to take the damages from both the tortfeasor or from one person, one tortfeasor out of the joint tortfeasor. It's totally on them. But for example, A and B together committed a tort and by which C has suffered some legal injury. Now it's on C that whether he wants to take the damages from A and B together or from A alone. Now if he takes from A and B, then they would contribute proportionately as they have done the wrong. If they had done the wrong 50-50%, then 50-50% would be the contribution. Otherwise, if 60-40, then 60-40 would be the contribution. But for example, if C has taken the whole compensation from A, now it is the duty of B to compensate A, because C has taken his compensation, the plaintiff is now out of the picture. Now it is between the two defendants, that is the joint tortfeasors, to suffer the damages equally, which they have paid, which one tortfeasor rather have paid to the plaintiff. Now the other joint tortfeasor, that is B, would compensate A because A has paid his share also. Simple, normal mathematics. I hope now it is